Blessed by the star shall light, you hear the echoes call. Walk with the 12 to save us, pray for peace to come, but will it ever come?
Welcome back to the land of the living, laddie. An old friend of mine was kind enough to carry you back to the wench after you tumbled down at the grip. Had the local leech give you the once-over, but he couldn't find nothing misplaced. Was worried you might have come down with the green rot. When the fog's cleared out your head, best you go and give your proper gramercies to old Blackburn. Said he'd be making his way back to Older, to some owl called the Walking Sands, found buried deep within the shadows of the Merchant's Ward. Told me to let you know he'd be waiting, but only once you've put a little meat on your bones. If you ask me, Older ain't more than a sand-crusted pile of puke dung baking in the desert sun, and the last place I'd send a friend. But you'd be a fool to turn your back on the call of fate. 12 be with ye, vagrant. Oi. I'll ring you on the ether once I think you're ready for old Blackburn. And remember, if you ever need an hand, you just holler. Savvy?
Deep in the sun-baked south, surrounded by the shifting sands of an endless desert, she rises. A solitary rose amidst the dust and rock, a symbol of defiance. Her name, Olda.
Ha! Nothing like the feel of Olda's sand under your feet.
Except for Olda's wine in your belly.
I is looking for a blade.
Seven summers since I was here last. Just look at all the people. Well, I haven't been to the market in ages.
Fragrance.
Look, Barbara! Fireworks!
Beautiful, aren't they?
Celia! Don't wander off too far now.
I'm so hungry, I could eat a goo boo.
As if one don't eat too fast.
And where in this marvelous city might you lovely ladies be staying?
Oh, you?
You there. What kept you?
Good to see you, boss.
The parade is about to begin. Make ready now.
You got it, boss. I won't let none go wrong.
Take it.
Oh.
As a precaution. Let us go.
For me? Really? Thank you.
Pretty, aren't they? Now be a sweetling and make sure everybody gets one, all right?
I will.
Ah, the famed songstress of Ulda, so flowers do grow in the desert.
This isn't right. It's gotten loose. No! Flamine!
Run for your lives!
Flamine, are you hurt? Flamine? Flamine.
Neo, look out!
Over here, you bloody beast! Hurry, go, now! Whoa!
Oh, dear gods. I hope I live to regret this.
Come on, hurry!
damn thing was rather taken with me. Any idea why that might be? And now our guest requests an encore. Come on!
Let's go!
You all right, boss?
See, you finally arrived.
Aye, welcome to the Walking Sands, a haven for those who have been chosen or been chosen to walk the glorious path of the Twelve.
When I found you in a heap near the God's Grip, I reckoned you might have fallen victim to one of them visions. If that be the case, the Undescendant Lady Minfilia would like to have a few words with you. You're not to worry, lad. The lady won't pass no judgment on you, only offer a bit of guidance. As will we all. If you let us. I've told the Undescendant what I know of your case, and now I must return to Velbrun to continue me search for others like ye. Here's to our past crossing again, whether it be in the future, or the past.
You must be the man of whom Walker Blackburn spoke. As you may have heard, I have many questions. But I seem to have forgotten my courtesies. Please, forgive me. My name is Minfilia, acting antecedent of the Path of the Twelve. Your bemused expression tells me you have not heard of us, which is to be expected. Ours is an underground organization dedicated to the documentation and research of divine intervention, or miracles, if you wish. We have walkers in each of Eorzea's city-states who investigate and report such phenomena. The man who directed you here, Blackburn, is one of many who serve as our eyes and ears. I shall not bother to elaborate on precisely what I mean by divine intervention, for I believe you have already experienced the phenomenon for yourself. You have a rare and special gift, Vagrant, and it is that gift that has led you here to us.
Eh? Fairly certain I found another welkin, Minfilia. It was lying face in the grass on the God's Grip near where Yashota lost the key.
After years of naught but rumors, the past several moon have seen the hill of reports on my desk grow into veritable mountains. Why the sudden influx? And why now, of all times? Which of the Twelve is waking men anew? Which, if any at all?
Ha! Those balls! When did ye? Ho!
It seems you have a keen eye, my friend. And it seems you have passed our test. Yes, yes, you are wondering how what you just witnessed, a conversation between myself and Blackburn, is even possible. Considering the fact that one of the involved persons left the Walking Sands nearly a bell ago. Well, that, Vagrant, is your gift. And I shall go one step further by suggesting that this is not the first time you have had such an experience. Come now, it is not, is it? Oh, you need not withhold your secrets from me. Here you are among friends, and I give you my solemn word that no harm shall befall you. However, it might still prove prudent to refrain from informing those not on the path of your awakening. Very few will understand this gift, but many will seek to judge you for possessing it. And what you possess is a rare talent which we have come to refer to as the Echo. We believe it is in some way connected to the strange phenomena which have been occurring in locations all over Eorzea. Were you not witness to the skies turning dark and showering the land with a storm of stars? Some of our brothers believe that those who partook in this celestial event were touched by the 12, and that this is how they came by their gift. The path is not only a place for study, but a refuge for those who have been touched in some way. We aim to uncover the meaning behind these unexplained events, while offering protection and guidance to those who hear the echo. But that is not all. My fellow walkers and I share the firm belief that this power was given to us for a purpose. Why entrust man with a gift so extraordinary, after all, if not to have him use it? And so we offer those who have been touched the means to use their power to better the world, to bring peace to Eorzea. So what say you, Vagrant? Now that you have heard who we are and what we are trying to accomplish, will you consider joining us? I beg your pardon. It was not my intention to force you into making a decision without allowing you time to consider my words. You are free to explore the building and speak with the others gathered here. When you feel ready to answer my question, visit me again here in the halls of the
Elder, first... but I only agree to this to know more about my, gift.
Very good. I pray together we can learn more of this gift. For though we have scoured the realm for nigh on 10 years, I fear there is still little we understand. Scores of men and women have passed through our doors looking to find answers, and scores have embarked on quests to do just that, but their efforts have gained us little, and many have not returned. Of those few who have, not one is willing to speak of what he saw at the end of the path. It is as if they all bore witness to a truth too terrible, or too shameful to be told. There are those here who would have me use the echo to delve into the past of the returned, yet it would be wrong of me to use my gift to tear that truth from them against their will. Were I to condone such an act of violation, we would be no better than the monstrous people think us already. But enough talk of the knowledge we lack. Let me tell you of what we do know. The echo allows you to breach the walls of a person's soul, and hear the resonations of their past. You will be in their memories, seeing things as they saw them. You may even interact with that which lies therein. However, the past is a stone tablet. You cannot incur what is already written. As an unexpected side effect of the gift, it seems the ability to reach into the soul of another also allows some of us to understand their words without having to comprehend the sounds they utter. In short, the Echo has granted these fortunate souls mastery of every language existing on Hydaelyn. Unfortunately, that is the sum of our understanding of this gift from the gods. Why, we are not even sure the gift is from the 12. It is certainly true that many of those who hear the echo also claim to have witnessed star showers. But who is to say that the star showers were even sent by them? It is a sad admission, but this very lack of knowledge accounts for much of the persecution faced by our walkers. The less that is known about something, the more it is distrusted by the masses. If we were to learn more of the Echo, perhaps we could educate people and help them to realize that we mean them no harm. But until we have learned that which we must teach them, we can expect only hatred. Do you understand?
Aye, understood.
Pardon my intrusion, Lady Mithelia, but has the adventurer made his decision?
Yes, he has, Tataru.
Then please, come this way. Please sign here. Thank you! Now I can ask you to remain here until everything is ready.
Excellent.
I must apologize for my lateness. I hope I have not kept my new companion waiting over long.
Allow me to introduce you to Vagrant Wristbreaker. An adventurer, a lately woken walker of the path, and your new companion.
It is an honor to finally make your acquaintance.
As are you.
I apologize for my haste, but I have an urgent matter to attend. May we meet again at the quicksand? Are you waiting for someone? A comely maiden, perhaps? Then may I suggest our finest table?
Which one is your finest?
Why, all of them are. This is amazing, Vagrant. I too was witness to a star shower. For so long, I thought I was alone, but to hear your story and how it echoes my own... Oh, thank you so much for sharing it with me. I've spent many nights asking myself why it was me who was chosen and not someone else. Someone more deserving. Someone more able. And I still do not have an answer. Yet I intend to find one, if it takes me the rest of my life. I believe the path of the 12 can lead me to that answer, but I do not know if I can bear the road alone. I would be honored if you'd agree to accompany me.
Maybe.
Most unexpected? I haven't said anything to offend, have I? The path is very strict about their pairings, and will most likely deny any requests for rematching. As much as I would like to accompany you on all of your travels, there are still many things which I feel I must discover on my own. However, we both walk the same path, and I would hope that if you ever have need of me, you will call. Just as I hope you would permit me to do the same, should I ever have need of you. I thank you again, Vagrant. I look forward to walking the path together.
Dara, Dara, battleground, battleground.
I apologize, my friends. I do not understand your words. Brothers, sisters, is there anyone here who can speak the language of the sylphs? Vagrant, would you be so kind as to use your gift and interpret for us what the sylphs are saying?
Dana ono retne. Iran met et rian olum.
Dinaun heh. Dinaun shindoin. Gio ringet. Ringet. Limaun. Limaun sred davrena.
Well, Vagrant, what are they saying? Metal ones. But that would mean... Are you quite certain, Vagrant? Gods, the Empire is attacking their home! Very well, I shall not stand by idly while the Garleans savage the realm. A rescue party shall be dispatched immediately. Vagrant, might I ask that you and Moondancer journey ahead to Moonspore Grove and assess the situation for the following party? You need not engage the enemy. Only observe from afar and gather information from any sylphs who may have evaded capture.
Finia Drex, Finia Finia Drex. Aron Gedeor Ereita Gedeorborn.
You have my thanks, Vagrant. And remember, you are not to attempt this mission alone. The matter is too important to permit such risk. You must promise me that you will contact Moondancer before you leave Ulda.
Vagrant! I hope I did not keep you waiting over much. I was so engrossed in my study of the Green Athenaeum's collection of old maps that I lost track of all time. Happily, those efforts have borne fruit, as I believe I know the approximate location of Moonspore Grove. To reach it, we must first travel into the East Forest to Camp Nine Ivies. There, I shall tell you more. Whatever has happened? Escaped? Then the Empire has found the grove. But how? What of your glamours?
Gentam
Dinazo, Granagdi Chadum. Dinau Ven Fred, Dinau Ginau, Dinau Ven Shal Dinar Canino. Erau in Ven Hem Grich Grad.
But what if we are discovered? No magics will protect us from the cannons of the Imperial Machina. We are certain to fail.
De Eons Vet Gret Samut Dre Hurama.
Dian Ge, Tarsi Juan Dolishindor. Difra.
Still, it all sounds dreadfully dangerous. If the smallest thing were to go awry... Might I have your wisdom, Vagrant?
I think we should go.
As you wish. I shall let myself be steeled by your resolve.
Fin the dregs, dinau anjal horn tunzat. Dinau vin elet antosun, gon gepam dinau lavun.
All right, bring it in!
close then.
But not all. I'm sorry. Whatever will you do now? The Empire will not relent until they have seen your kind eliminated. Have you considered fleeing? Perhaps somewhere to the east or south?
Chindo, Vincendo Zade, Virana.
Summon the Primal? Such an act would most surely provoke the Empire into attacking the entire realm. No city-state would survive. What do you mean, changed? You are quite mistaken, I assure you. I see the evil at hand all too clearly. I also see that we must stand together as one against our common enemy if we are to have any hope of victory.
Is this the scouting party sent ahead by the antecedent?
It looks like they did a little more than scouting, I would say.
It matters not. You'll tell us what you found and then leave this place. Your presence here is no longer required.
Who are these men? I do not like the look of them. Perhaps we should take our leave of this place before matters worsen. I thank you for today, Vagrant. I do not believe I would have had the courage to aid the Sylphs on my own. I now see why Lady Minfilia insists all the walkers be paired. I will have to thank her as well, as should you, my dear friend.
I feel congratulations are in order. You have performed far beyond expectations. I hope the path will be able to call upon your invaluable assistance for a long time to come.
Vagrant, I am pleased to see you made it back unharmed. I am aware that you have already made a full report to Tataru, so I will not trouble you to repeat it. While it is not much, let this small stipend serve as a token of my appreciation. Of all our appreciation. May it be the first of many.